So in terms of the tau knockout cells, the thing is tau protein is not only implicated in Alzheimer's disease. Mutations in tau protein is also one of the major pathological cause for FTD, ALS, PSP, so many other tauopathies that is implicated with the tau protein. So with the tau knockout human stem cell model, we are hoping to provide a good platform, a disease model, not just for AD research, but also for different types of dementia that is generally categorized as tauopathy, because there's something wrong with the tau. They have tau aggregates, they have tau mutations, things like that. So that's what the impact we are trying, you know, the first impact we are trying to have in terms for the research community. In terms of the disease modeling and perhaps drug development, we are trying to have a model that we know there's a lack of tau protein. We know there are certain aspects that is protected from amyloid beta treatment. If we can do this high throughput in the 96 well plate, so this will help us with a drug development, drug discovery, because we can basically standardize the phenotypes with tau knockout or tau wild type cells, right? Treat them with various drugs and see if there's any sort of rescue or deterioration in a high throughput way. So that's the second step we are trying to make. In my personal view, second sort of impact that we are trying to have in terms of community. And then the third impact, I guess, is the mechanism, because for the protection from tau knockout cells from the amyloid beta, it's been shown in mice, but it has not always been very consistent. Depends on the age of the mice, the mouse strain, depends on which lab created the tau knockout mice. So it's a little bit inconsistent. And with this tau, with this human model, we hope to try to, you know, bring those inconsistencies together and try to see that, okay, what's common between human and mice? And then maybe that's something we can focus on. So in terms of the mechanism, we hope to make it a little bit clearer for the research community. So, you know, in the future, whether we're using mouse model, fly model, worms model, human model, we can perhaps harmonize the phenotypes, what we are trying to see. And then, you know, perhaps spend more time on something that on the phenotype, perhaps that could yield better, more reliable results. Of course, eventually for the drug development, for disease modeling, that can lead to a better chance for a cure.